Today we're changing the exhaust on the M340. If you've been watching the videos, I've got an Active Autowerke Catted Downpipe paired with the stock Catback exhaust. So thank you guys for watching. Let's jump into it. We just pulled up to this place. Took almost 2 hours to get up here. Gotta love traffic, but we're gonna go in there. We're gonna get everything dialed up, and then come back and we'll see what she sounds like. So we'll see. So here's how she's looking beforehand. All right, so quick little update. I got off the phone with the guy who's working on the car, and we discussed the valve. Because there's one valve on the passenger rear area of the Catback, and we ultimately decided not to keep the valve. The reason for that is because he said, you know, if you keep the valve, it basically shuts off that entire side of the exhaust, and you know, obviously it's all going to be rerouted to the other side, and there's no muffler. So what that means is you're forcing all that air out to one side, and it's not going to quiet it down. It's basically pointless to leave the valve there, so taking the valve off and then, you know, the little clip that plugs into the valve actuator or whatever is going to get, you know, packed away. So there's not going to be a valve, so, you know, clicking it from comfort mode to sport mode or whatever is not going to, you know, make it louder or quieter. The only thing that might make it quieter is the fact that the tuning is different in those two drive modes. So obviously in sport mode, we'll get loud big pops and stuff, which I mean, hopefully they'll be loud. I'm hoping that, you know, the car is a lot louder. That's why I'm doing it. But we'll see. I'm walking back to the shop right now, and I'm really excited. So let's see what she sounds like. All right, so here's how she's looking. Oh man. No check engine light or anything. I was told that, you know, there shouldn't be a check engine light. Also did some research too, just to verify that. But dang, dude, that's loud. I mean, I'm sitting here and it's, you know, warming up, and that's crazy. That is ridiculously loud. Are you kidding me? Still driving. I have it in Eco Pro right now, so kind of like how I was talking about sport mode, you know, obviously we get the loud obnoxious burbles and stuff. Eco mode, because of the tuning, you know, it shifts real low. It's really not that bad driving. I mean, you can hear it. Certain RPMs, it drones really bad. Probably, I want to say like in between maybe 2500 to 3000 RPMs, and then I guess really low in the RPMs, like I'm talking maybe between 1 and maybe 1500 RPMs, it like rumbles. Like my seat turns into a freaking massage chair the whole car just rumbles. It's loud. It is really loud. I don't know how well it's gonna pick up on the camera, but like right now, see, like right now we're really low in the RPMs, and I mean, it's crazy. It sounds like I'm driving a semi. Exterior clips and then some clips, you know, kind of getting on it a little bit, and then hopefully that'll give a better rundown on what it really sounds like, you know, throughout the RPM range. Little startup roar from the gas station. Ooh. This is ridiculous. Wow. That sounds crazy. That idle is loud. A second and listen to that. My goodness. That's crazy. That's crazy. And you know, the inside of these M340s are so insulated, you know, to the point where like, it can almost get pretty quiet in here. But with this, I mean, it's so loud in here. It's way louder than my built STI was. at least in the cabin. I'll have to listen to the footage and see what it sounds like from the outside, but like, you got to be kidding me. Because this thing is crazy. Pretty good investment. The clips that I was able to capture today were able to truly show you guys how loud the car is. It's wicked. I mean, it is wicked. From the interior, it's crazy because every single car that I've owned, except for like two, I think, have had modified exhaust systems, and not one of them has been as loud as that BMW is on the inside. And that's crazy to me because that car is also the quietest, the most insulated vehicle I've ever owned. So it's gonna take a little bit of adjustment to get used to. So yeah, I mean, I haven't really gotten to hear it from the outside other than like cold starts or warm starts. So I don't really know to the full extent how loud it actually is on the outside, but because, you know, obviously the car is so insulated, I imagine it's really loud. Yeah, so if you guys can see under there, obviously no muffler. You got the, there you go, the two pipes right there that were welded in. But yeah, no, it's sweet, well worth it. I'm happy.
So just hit me when you're ready to figure this shit out. You're always saying it's not the right time to talk, you're always doing this weird shit, so just let me know when it's not a bad time.